back on Sebastian. So, I know you haven't driven it yet, but what's your first feeling of the new car at first sight?
Well, I think obviously that is a change in color for me, so it's a new experience, but I think the car looks beautiful. To get to see how it comes together is always something special every year when there's a new car and you see the first bits and then finally the final car all assembled. I think it's something special, so I can't wait to go on track and see how it feels.
One question drivers normally get asked about is about the driving position and seat. So coming from another team, how do you feel? Is it any different from what we used to be? Do you feel comfortable in the car?
Well, obviously changing team, there's a lot of different things. Not so much about the driving position because obviously it's custom made, so you can ask for things that you like. But in terms of the steering wheel layout and the strategy is a bit different. So people talk, about probably the same things, but in a different language, meaning they use different words for probably similar actions. So it's always a lot of new things to learn, but I think we'll have the time through the beginning of the year, through testing, to get into the rhythm.
It's not just about changing colors, it's about wearing red, the red of the school year. So how do you feel about it? You're settling in with the life in Italy and the school year?
Yeah, more and more so. I think the first time when I arrived last year and I had the opportunity to test the car from 2012 was already something magical, so something really, really special. And of course, to now, get going and start the 2015 season properly, it will be something special. But yeah, I think when the flag drops in Melbourne, I think will be again a very special thing. The first race with Ferrari, everything is red, and it's a very special color because it means so much with so much history. So I'm very much looking forward to it.
So one long season ahead, and team needs to recover from last year. So what could realistic expectation be for the coming season?
Well, I think there's a lot of change going on. There's a lot of new people in new positions, so including myself. So it always takes a bit of time to settle in until you really start to make proper progress. But I'm confident that we are going in the right direction. But I think it would be wrong to immediately expect a lot of us. Obviously, also we need to remember we're coming from a 2014 season where there was one team very dominant. So it will be difficult to be right there from the beginning. But I think for us the main target is to start to really work together, start to make progress, and hopefully catch up more and more and more as the season progresses.
So you and Kimi have been known to get along quite well together. How are you looking forward to working with him?
Well, I don't expect any problems. I mean, he will be a difficult teammate to beat on the track because he's very quick, very talented, but I think off track we get along well, and usually there's not so much words being exchanged, but it's always very straightforward, which is something I appreciate in Kimi, and is not happening that often in Formula One.
You've been with the Italian team before, so did you brush up some of the Italian? Are you going to speak some of the language, or?
Yeah, I think I'm getting into it. Obviously, it helps the more time you spend with the team. The more you listen to the language and so on. On top, I try to obviously learn a little bit as the season goes on. But coming from Toro Rosso, the Italian seems to come back. I think I understand fairly well, but I lack a little bit of vocabulary to really start speaking on my own.
And finally, Maurizio said he would be happy with one win this season. Do you share his view?
Well, I think we would be happy, but of course we'd be happier if we would win more. So, but. As I said, you have to be realistic. There's a lot of change that happened over winter. So I think the most important is that we, start getting into the groove quickly in winter testing, and then, we start to make progress. If the situation is like last year, it will be very difficult to really fight for victories. But of course, it's our goal. That's why we're here. We're not here to finish second.
Is there any specific track you're looking forward to in the calendar?
I'm always looking forward to go to Japan. Suzuka, I think, is more or less my favorite track, but there's a lot of events in the calendar. Melbourne, I think, is a great place to start the season. It's a great city, a great place, great vibe, a great track on top. Singapore is one of the events I enjoy a lot. It's a proper night race and a very technical and demanding track. So yeah, there's not really a race I don't like, so I'm looking forward to all the races.